the last episode, we have discussed the role of aggregate planning in supply chain. In this episode, we will discuss about the different aggregate planning strategies. In preparing the aggregate plan, the planner makes a trade-off among the various variables to optimize the cost. The most profitable combination of variables will be used to achieve this goal. Basically, a company attempts to use a combination of three variables, namely capacity, inventory, and back ordering. If a company uses only one variable in preparing the aggregate plan, it is called as pure strategy. But when a company uses more than one variable in preparing an aggregate plan, it is called as a mixed strategy. Mixed strategy can be chase strategy, capacity strategy, or a level strategy. Now let us discuss about the various mixed strategies. Chase strategy. This strategy in aggregate planning focuses on meeting the required demand by varying the capacity and the workforce size for the respective periods. When this strategy is employed, the workforce will be hired when the demand increases for that period, and the workforce will be laid off when the demand decreases for that period. Similarly, the capacity of production is also varied as per the demand. Capacity strategy. This strategy in aggregate planning focuses on meeting the demand by planning a constant workforce for the available capacity and uses time as a variable to meet the increase in demand. When the demand increases, the manufacturer works for overtime to meet the demand of that period, but when the demand decreases, the manufacturer works with less number of machines to meet the demand for that period, resulting in idle time for the capacity. This strategy is more practically used than the chase strategy, as varying the workforce size will lead to lower morale among the workforce and may affect the productivity of the organization. The third strategy is known as the level strategy. This strategy in aggregate planning focuses on meeting the demand by planning a constant workforce and a constant capacity to meet the demand requirements. When the demand is low, extra production is accumulated as inventory and used later. If the demand is high, the demand is met with the accumulated inventory. If the accumulated inventory is not enough to meet the demand, then the manufacturer uses back-ordering strategy and makes the customer wait for the product till the next period, so that the production of next period fulfills the demand for the next requirement of the supply chain. Methods of preparing an aggregate plan. There are two methods of preparing an aggregate plan. Method one is the graphical and charting technique. Method two is the mathematical approach. Under the mathematical approach, we have transportation methods, linear decision rules, linear programming, and simulation. The graphical approach to aggregate planning is simple. The steps involved in the graphical approach are given below. First step is to forecast demand for each period. Second step is to determine the capacity for regular time production, overtime production, and subcontracting. Third step is to determine the labor cost, hiring and firing cost, and inventory holding cost. The next step is to consider the company policy, which may apply to the workers or to the inventories. Then, based on all the information available, our aggregate production plan is prepared and compared with the total cost of various alternates which are available, and the best plan is selected for implementation. Mathematical techniques. An aggregate planning problem can be formulated as a linear programming problem with the objective function of maximizing profit or minimizing cost with the constraints. Solving this linear programming problem will optimize the decision and give the projection of various quantities to be produced to satisfy the demand. Similarly, an aggregate production planning problem can be formulated as a transportation model and solved. The capacity and the demand constraints are taken as demand and supply for a transportation problem. The unit cost of manufacturing using different controllable variables are taken as unit cost of transportation of a transportation problem. Solving this problem and finding the optimum allocation will give us the solution for the aggregate production problem which is being taken for consideration. Similarly, simulation is used as a method of solving in aggregate planning. An aggregate planning problem can be developed into a simulation model with an environment and tested under various conditions to find a suitable production plan for implementation. The models developed can be part of the decision support system of the organization, which will help them in planning and analyzing the various options in aggregate planning with the inputs from all stakeholders. This type of simulation models will help the manufacturing plant to formulate an appropriate manufacturing strategy to meet the demand of the supply chain. In this episode, we have discussed the various methods of aggregate production planning. In the next episode, we will discuss an example of aggregate production planning in supply chain management. Thank you.